Let's click the Sketch tab to move to the Sketch window for this estimate. The Sketch window contains a toolbar that displays the sketch tools we'll be using for this estimate. The Sketch workspace, by default, contains an N with an arrow that shows where north is on the sketch. Our hand drawing from the lost site also shows north. We will begin drawing the estimate at the top left of our workspace, which is the northwest corner of the house. Most estimators find that it is a good practice to generally sketch from left to right and top to bottom. This first room is bedroom 1. We click the Room button and move our cursor over the sketch workspace. The image of a room appears under our cursor with the default inside dimensions of 12 feet by 12 feet. We move our cursor to the top left corner of the workspace, then click and hold the left mouse button. Now we drag the mouse until we have a rectangle that has inside dimensions of 16 feet 4 inches by 15 feet 6 inches and release the left mouse button. To fine-tune the dimensions, we click the wall handle and drag, then click the dimension numbers and enter the correct number. We click on Room 1 and change the default name to Bedroom 1. Now let's add the closet to this bedroom. Our on-site drawing shows the closet has inside dimensions of 3 feet 2 inches by 7 feet 7 inches. We could add this offset to Bedroom 1 by using the Room tool and attaching it, but we'll add the closet using the Square Break tool. We click the Square Break button, then move the mouse cursor over the east wall. Dimensions now appear on both sides of our cursor. Our plan shows the inside dimensions of the closet are 7 feet 7 inches. The default width of the walls in Sketch and the wall width we are using on this plan is 4 inches. So we need to add 2 inches to our 7 feet 7 inch dimension and make the square break at 7 feet 9 inches. We move the cursor until it shows the 7 feet 9 inch dimension, then click the left mouse button. This gives us the inside dimension of 7 feet 7 inches shown on our on-site plan. Now we move the mouse cursor over the new wall handle located above the break. We press and hold the Control key, then click and hold the left mouse button and drag the wall to the right. We drag the wall until our inside dimensions are 3 feet 2 inches. We fine-tune dimensions by clicking and dragging the wall we want to change, then clicking on the dimension numbers and typing the correct number. Now let's change the name of this closet and attach it to Bedroom 1 as a subroom. We move the cursor over the room name and click the right mouse button. The right-click menu appears and we select Properties. The Room Properties window appears and we change the name to Closet 1. We make the closet a subroom by clicking the Subgroup of drop-down button and selecting Bedroom 1 from the drop-down list. When we click away from the Room Properties window, notice the display for Closet 1. It contains the name of the closet with the number 1 inside of parentheses. This tells us the closet is a subroom and that it is the first or number 1 subroom. Placing rooms as subrooms helps Xactimate calculate totals for you in a more logical way. This will be important when we start entering estimate line items such as carpet and paint.